Hello, Hera. You won't believe what happened to me last time I went to the vet. She told me that I need to lose weight based on the average weight of a cat my age. Unbelievable.
Hans, many of your exciting questions are around treats and food. You must really like tasty food.
Oh, I definitely do. I want to convince my vet that her numbers do not make sense to me and that my weight is just fine. I thought about all my feline friends nearby, who certainly weigh much more than I do. So yesterday, I asked 10 fellow cats who were just passing by to accompany me to the supermarket 3 blocks away and use a scale on the back of the building to record their weights. And guess what? The average weight of the 10 cats was 15 pounds, and I only weighed 12 pounds. Do you think this data will be sufficient to get me out of the diet I was put on?
Well, do you think that if you measure the weight of another 100 cats, the average weight would still be 15 pounds? What if the 10 cats you brought to the scale at the supermarket were just much heavier than most cats?
Okay, you have a point. Let me contact my friends in the surrounding neighborhoods and I will show you that I don't need any weight loss diet.
Looking forward to seeing your results, Hans.
Hera, you were right. I invited 100 friends to the scale behind the supermarket, and guess what? The average weight now was 10 pounds. Very different from the first measure I got. Unfortunately, my vet may be right. I may be having more treats than I should.
Well, the statistics from the International Cat Society show that the average weight of adult cats ranges between 8.8 and 11 pounds, which is close to the average weight you obtained yesterday from weighing 100 of your friends.
But Hera, I have a question though. Why did I get such an extreme number the first time?
Likely you were fooled by chance. You said you just brought 10 cats to the scale and they were just passing by, right? Just by chance, the 10 cats were further away from the average adult cat weight, which ended up being quite a high number. This type of issue is simply chance variation, which is called random error in statistical lingo. And we can mitigate the influence of this type of variation by increasing the number of observations.
Well, for a moment, I thought I'd be able to convince my vet that I don't need to be on a diet. Wait a minute. What if the scale at the supermarket is flawed? Let's say the scale always shows more weight than the actual weight of a cat. For example, it could be that the scale adds 2 pounds to any measure. How many friends should I weigh to overcome this flaw? 1,000? 10,000? 100,000?
It would have been best to check that the scale worked correctly before using it. If the scale is flawed and is adding 2 pounds to every measure, there is no number of cats that you can invite that would solve this problem. The only way to avoid this mistake is by checking the scale to make sure it is calibrated before beginning your measurements. Otherwise, all measures will be wrong. Researchers call this type of mistake systematic error or bias.
I see. So we minimize random error by increasing sample size and bias or systematic error by using proper methods. Okay, well, not sure I want to check the scale. I mean, maybe it shows 2 pounds less than the correct weight. If so, I actually weighed 14 pounds. Okay, so rather than checking if the scale is well calibrated, I just think it'll be better for my psyche to eat one less treat a day. Thank you, Hera.